The delegate and protocol pattern is a one-to-one communication pattern in Swift. It allows one view to communicate with another view. For example, the view controller in our bottom sheet is communicating with the main view controller. It's communicating that when the iPhone button is tapped, okay, main view controller, go ahead and update your UI with all the iPhone stuff. Again, it's a one-to-one communication set up with delegates and protocols. Today's video is sponsored by Squarespace. Delegates and protocols can be confusing, so I do have a starter project to keep the video as focused as possible on the topic. I will review it here in 30 seconds. It's mostly UI code. You can see the screen I have set up with an image view, a UI label, and a button at the bottom. That's what you see here, product image view, name label, product button. And then most of the code on this screen, this setup UI, is just all UI code, right? Where I'm configuring the image, configuring the label, configuring the button, and then setting up constraints. You can see the image there. And then the other piece of code is actually presenting the other view controller, the bottom sheet, right? So when I tap choose product, we get this bottom sheet. And that's what's happening right here in this present product selection VC. You can see we're setting up the sheet with the detents medium. That's how it goes halfway up. We're showing the grabber, and the view controller I'm showing is the product selection VC. Let's go to the product selection view controller. Let's get the simulator back up. Again, just three buttons. iPhone button, iPad button, MacBook Pro button. All this code here, it looks like a lot of code, I know. It's just setting up the UI. I'm configuring three buttons and then setting the constraints on those three buttons. And I do have actions for those three buttons, right? When the iPhone button is tapped. Right now, we're just dismissing it. Tapping on the MacBook, we're just dismissing it. That's the overview of the starter project. As you can see, I've done nothing with delegates and protocols. It's just purely UI setup. But let's start talking about those delegates and protocols. As I mentioned in the intro, we need to communicate between these two view controllers, our product selection view controller and our main view controller, right? The product selection one is the one with the buttons, main view controller is in the back. So that is a perfect scenario for a one-to-one communication, which again, delegates and protocols. Let me back up and explain the concept of delegates, because this was a light bulb moment for me to understand the concept of a delegate. Basically, a delegate is sitting back, waiting to be told when and what to do. You don't call delegate methods themselves. They get called automatically when they're told what to do. That's the big picture context to keep in mind as we build this. It'll make a lot more sense once we, you know, code it up. Okay, so if the delegate is sitting around waiting to be told when and what to do, something has to give it that order. Something has to give it those instructions. And I like to use a boss and an intern analogy. So in our case, the product selection VC, this card right here, is going to be telling the main view controller what to do. The product selection view controller, the half sheet, has all the information. It knows what was tapped. It knows the iPhone was tapped. It knows the iPad is tapped. And it has to pass that message along to the main view controller so it will update its view here. I don't have the code set up, so it's not updating, but this image will change to an iPhone or a Mac, whatever. So in our case, the product selection VC is the boss. The main view controller is the intern. The main view controller is just sitting around, hey, tell me what to do and I'll do it, right? It's just waiting to be told. So to set that up in our product selection VC, which is going to be the boss in this case, we need to create a protocol. So protocol, and we'll call it product selection delegate. And what a protocol is essentially, to keep it super simple, is a list of commands. Think of it like the job description, right? If you're going to be my intern, here are the tasks that you need to know how to do. So for us, we're going to create a function called did select product, and we're going to pass in the name of the product, which is a string, and also the image name, so we know what image to update. And by the way, my image names in my assets, I have these built into the project, which you can download. I have a link to in the description to a Dropbox file to download the project, but you can see I have the iPhone, iMac, super small. But those are my assets. The images are in there, and you can see their names, iPad, iPhone, Mac. So I pull in my simulator, so you can see here, we need to pass in the name of the product so we can update the label. It won't say Apple product line, it'll say iPhone or whatever. And then we need to pass the image name so it knows what image to show here. Now, in our simple example, we're only having one command, right? This is like the job description. This is what the intern needs to know how to do. You could have did action two, func did action three. And these are just kind of placeholders for other things that could potentially be done on your screen. I just want to point out that a protocol can have many commands, right? It's a list of instructions, a list of commands. Our simple example is only going to have one, but again, I want to make it clear, you can't have more than one. Now that we have our job description, essentially, right, telling the intern what you need to know how to do, we need to actually have a quote-unquote intern on our product selection screen. So for that, we have a variable called delegate, and that is of type product selection delegate. That's what we just created up here, and that is going to be an optional, because we're gonna have to tell this view controller what the delegate is. In our case, it's gonna be the main view controller. We'll come back to that in a second. But I wanna set up our product selection view controller, which in this case is our boss. And I know I'm repeating myself, but I think repetition is the key to really learn this stuff. So like I said, job description in the protocol. Here is the actual job position, if you want to use that analogy. So now our boss is set up. We have the job description, we have the position. Now let's go to our view controller and essentially apply for the job. So to do that, we need to conform to the product selection delegate. So in order to do that, you do comma, product selection delegate up here in your class definition of the view controller. Now Xcode's gonna yell at me, do a command B. It says type view controller does not conform to protocol selection delegate. Because in order to conform to product selection delegate, we have to have these functions in place, this did select product, the tasks of the job. So back to view controller, Xcode will fill these stubs in. Now this may look familiar. If you've ever built a table view in UIKit, you have to implement the table view delegate methods. If you've ever done like location manager, there's a location update delegate method. And again, those methods are just sitting back, waiting to be told what to do, and they fire off automatically. And you'll see that, you'll notice, I'm not actually gonna call did select product in the view controller. We're gonna call it from somewhere else, and then that will fire off automatically. So I actually don't like the position of this. My variable's up top, and then my function. So we'll put it down below view did load. So now that I have signed up for the job, I need to do something when I get told what to do this job. So in our case, we're gonna set the product image view. Let me pull up the simulator again, right? The product image view is the image of Apple products, and then the product name label is where it says Apple product line. So I wanna do product name label dot text equals name, and you'll see we're gonna pass in this information. And I wanna do product image view dot image equals UI image named image name, right? We're passing in this information. We haven't done that yet. You'll see that in a second. But our intern, right? Our intern has signed up for the job. I'm conforming to the delegate. And I know what to do when I'm told, hey, do your job. Like I said, I don't call this did select product from the view controller. The view controller is a delegate. It's sitting back waiting to be told what to do. Once it gets that order, it's gonna go ahead and do this job. So that's the premise of the delegate. So there's two more steps we need to do. If I go back to my product selection VC to continue with this analogy, I have my job description, I have the job opening. Well, back in my view controller, I say, hey, I'm applying for the job and I know how to do the job, so let me get hired, so to speak. So here where I'm present product selection VC, right? I'm creating it, I'm initializing a brand new one, and then I'm doing all the modal presentation to make it a half sheet, that's what all that code is, and then I present it. Well, now that I have this destination VC, I can set the delegate here. So I can say destination VC.delegate equals self. Now self in this case is the view controller. I am signing up for this job. Remember, the destination VC is a product selection VC. So if VC is short for view controller, if you haven't picked that up yet. So now that's this variable right here that I am setting. When I create a brand new product selection VC, I'm also initializing it with a delegate that I have set here equal to self. The view controller is saying, hi, sign me up. I wanna be your delegate. I wanna be your intern. So now that this is connected, the main view controller, right, that has our product images is ready to do the job. The final piece of the puzzle in our product selection VC, or in this case, our boss, is to actually give the order, give the command to do the job. Now, when do we want to do that? Again, pulling up the simulator. We want to do that when the iPhone button is tapped, when the iPad button is tapped, when the MacBook Pro is tapped. We're going to give the order, hey, update your UI with the iPad, update your UI with the MacBook. So to give those orders, we do that in our iPhone button tapped. Now, this is just my educational example with the buttons. This could be anything going on in this screen. Maybe it's on a countdown timer. Maybe it's when they push a button six times, like whatever triggers this, right? In our case, it's a button tap, but this can be any trigger where you call this line of code, where you say, okay, delegate. Now you say did select product, and because we tapped the iPhone, right, we're in the iPhone button tapped, the product name I want to pass in is iPhone 14, and then the image name is just iPhone. So you're telling the delegate, okay, do your job, delegate, and here's the information you need to do your job. And if I go back to the view controller, this did select product is gonna get fired off, and whatever name and image name I pass in, on my main view controller, I'm going to set my product name label to that name, and the product image view to the image. Let's run this and see it in action, and then we'll set up the other two. So I'm choosing product, tap iPhone. Now my delegate, the main view controller, knows, hey, I'm gonna update my label to iPhone 14, and I'm gonna update my image to the iPhone. So let's go back and do the other ones. So back to product selection VC, I'm gonna copy and paste this command here. So copy that, put it in the iPad button tap, put it in the MacBook button tap. So instead of iPhone 14, we're gonna say iPad Air, and then that image is just iPad. And then instead of iPhone 14 for the MacBook, we're gonna say MacBook, and then the image is Mac. So now when I run it, no matter what button I tap, it should update accordingly. So choose product, hit the iPad, bam, there's the iPad Air. Choose product, hit the MacBook Pro, there's the MacBook. I guess I could have called that MacBook Pro on the label. That's neither here nor there. But now you can see there's two views communicating in a one-to-one pattern. If you're getting ready to apply for iOS developer jobs, having a portfolio can really help you stand out. And that brings me to today's sponsor, Squarespace. Squarespace is an all-in-one platform to help you get that iOS developer portfolio, blog, or personal website up and running very quickly. Now I know, we're all developers with the skills and the desire to build the web page ourselves, but I would argue there's an opportunity cost to your time. If you're an iOS developer trying to build a great product, a great app, maybe spending a lot of time learning the ins and outs of web development, responsive design, isn't the best way to spend your time. That's why I recommend Squarespace to build that personal website, the blog, your portfolio, or maybe a landing page for your app. They have all kinds of beautiful themes and templates to get you started. They handle all the analytics and the SEO for you. Again, it just saves you so much time so you can get back to doing what you want to do, and that is building iOS apps. So when you're ready to get started, go to squarespace.com to start your free trial. And when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/SeanAllen to get 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain.